And now it looks like we're about to get into the match right now. The first set here, Dark Wizzy versus Light. Let's go.
So the FD was just for hand warmers, and we're on PS2.
Let's do it.
Because PS2 make the best games. There we go. Up throw into the down air, another up air. And like we were talking about, Wizzy going to try to rack up damage early on, but Light firing back with a dash attack into a nice little string of his own.
So fast, and here comes the pressure already. Light is just so incredibly fast on top of Dark Wizzy at every angle, man.
Yeah.
Okay, here it is right now. Good mix-up, too, on the knockdown. I didn't think he would have been able to actually confirm from that far. But yeah, there's so much hit stun on that Nair.
Yeah, and Fox is just so incredibly fast. And we talked about the two-framing. I told you. I thought it was just going to be a dash attack. But no, we got the down-angled forward smash Wizzy placing it perfectly. And we're going to see how Light responds. He's got to get the stock off quickly because Mario can just ruin your percent in a hurry.
Yep, and you saw right there how Light trying to respect Wizzy's landing there with the neutral, but big up smash right here, tying up the stocks.
That could be so scary if you jump into Fox with an aerial, especially if you fully commit to it. Don't cross up. You can just land right in front of him. That's a free up smash. Now we're down back to even, two stocks apiece.
Oh, a nice parry right there, giving him the opportunity to turn around and grab. It looked like he expected a cross up.
A bit of back and forth. Mm-hmm.
Looking at both of these characters, though, you know, when it comes to Fox, he does have some pretty good long-range tools in the blaster, but the way that Dark Wizzy's playing, he could never get a chance to actually focus on using that. Yep. And, of course, Mario has a cape, too.
So dash attack. We're going to go for the forward air. Hasn't boxed out here, and I'm interested to see how Light controls the space. Mm-hmm. Dark Wizzy, we've been seeing it all weekend, one of the best in the world at controlling the Pokeball in the middle, at keeping his opponent boxed out.
I never even focused on that, but yeah, he loves center stage.
Yes.
That's his favorite thing whenever he's facing off against characters. Tried to see beautiful stuff right there. The ledge trapping, the setup with the snipe, and caught the roll right towards center just to get the up smash.
Yeah, and I think that's sort of a forced error, because if you go for the dash attack, what your opponent's going to do is just kind of mash roll because they want to immediately get on stage, and that's what you saw from Wizzy. And he loves that up smash at about 10% of the stage because he knows so many people want to force that roll in, and now he's got a pretty hefty lead.
Yep, and we did see right there one of the reasons why this is a tough matchup. But instead, Light still getting that stock. But one of the things I wanted to touch on were those trades that happened prior to Light getting that up tilt back air. It makes it very difficult for him to chain those up airs as he does on other characters. He has to be on point.
Yeah, you got the Mario neutral air just coming out so quickly. He's got the cape, the stall, too. So has a lot of tools to get away. But right now,
there
Light looking airtight. That's what he needed. You were right, though. He disrupted it. But we're still basically dead even between these two guys.
Oh, and right there, here's another thing to mention. With this particular stage, right, if he happens to knock Dark Wizzy on either of these side platforms, up smash is tall, it's high enough to actually hit on the platform. So that could be a really good opportunity. But the up smash, invincible tool. You can't land on Dark Wizzy, not with these high percents. And Fox's Light, too.
Oh, and Wizzy actually going for a forward air there. Not sure if that was a misinput. It looked like he tried to land, but there's the reverse up smash. And that will happen. I think that's a game one thing. Because, like, that was raw.
Yes.
That had no seasoning. That was just like, all right, I'm throwing it out right now. I would be surprised if he got it like that again later on in this set. We know that he goes for the up smash, but usually it's, like, more conditioned. That one was just like a game one last stock. All right, rip, let it rip.
One thing that comes to mind is understanding that when a person goes for their initial dash, usually you don't have access to a block immediately. I wonder if he was trying to react to the fact that he was in his initial dash animation, so he has more than enough time, 15 frames of lag before you're able to block to get that up smash. That might be it.
Yeah, and Foxes love doing that, obviously. Love dashing around. Let's see what the next stage is. We're going back to PS2. I definitely, you know, I think this makes sense. I think the last match could have gone either way. It was just Wizzy who came out ahead. Light's got to be careful at these low percents off stage, though. Wizzy can just ruin your stock immediately. Good up B out of shield. Now Light with a slight deficit.
Yeah, right there, just telling Light, man. So usually Fox, when they go for their F tilts, right, they try to change it to the dash attack as well. But right here, you can see Dark Wizzy just testing how tight his combos are again. Oh, that backer felt louder than usual.
Yeah.
Boosh.
Yeah.
It's probably the Genesis 7 volume.
Yeah.
Got that bass here in the Paramount
Theater.
It feels
so good, man. Mm-hmm. Just the acoustics in this arena, the crowd here, it's just an incredible feeling. We'll see if Light can further his run. Keep enjoying these sets. Wizzy's going to make it hard for him. Air dodge is right into the grab. There's a back throw. We're going to charge up the flood. Let's see where it leads. Oh, it's leading to him way off stage.
Okay, nice. He gets the two frame with the dash attack. Waiting for that opportunity and a perfect drift to get that back air, dude. Dark Woodsy, he's here to play, man.
Yeah. And the timing on that is a lot harder than it might look, because Vox players can be pretty tricky in how they're recovering. Mm-hmm. But Light getting a little antsy trying to get back to the stage. And I think Wizzy is punishing every single time. Excellent dash away to really control the space. And now he has a full stock advantage.
Okay, he's able to get the right hit on those down there. It's just a chain of dash attack, but still needs more damage on the board. Okay, I like that catch right there in the dash in. One thing, though, that Dark Wizzy, actually jumping in the air, and that up smash, like I told you before, look how high it hits, dude.
It's such a good anti-air, mm-hmm. and against a character literally named Jumpman, like just being able to catch him again and again. Light here doing some jumping of his own, though, doing some flips, 72%, 79, forces Wizzy to air dodge, but he can't follow up, so he's going to eat that back air.
I feel like forcing Wizzy to air dodge is a big statement right there. That's a good thing for Light, right? Because before you saw Dark Wizzy, he was comfortable with just nairing his way out, but now he understands that Light is getting way more threatening here with these combos.
Yes. Yeah, he's kind of waiting a little bit. He's tightening up a lot, and I think that that's really what can benefit players in a best of five, because it's a lot easier to beat somebody in a 2 out of 3 or to cheese them in a 2 out of 3 than a 3 out of 5. But you can see Dark Wizzy running right under Light again, jumping a little bit too much, getting an up smash, and now Light getting a little cheeky with 2 up smashes immediately.
Nice. Going straight for the edge there, and I'm surprised that Dark Wizzy didn't catch that roll. Here it is again. Ledge trap situation set up. Wow, and he actually footstooled out of there.
Yeah, that could have gone very badly for Wizzy, but instead Light's the guy playing catch-up, goes for the dash attack, does not land.
Yeah, but instead Light, yeah, getting inside with that neutral air, jumping over the fireball, has to watch out.
Yeah. One thing that I'm kind of interested in is, like I was saying, Wizzy is like the king of holding center. He wants to hold neutral.
Yes.
Doesn't really matter against Fox that much because his main killing tool is up smash. So holding center stage isn't as good because you're going to die off the top anyway.
This is quite true. And one thing that does help out Wizzy in this matchup, though, whenever you're fighting against Fox, right, blocking is usually a pretty good option. You know, you don't have to worry about him KOing you, right, off of a throw, things like that. But seeing all that pressure that Light exerts, I don't think you necessarily want to sit and shield the entire time, right?
Yeah.
Kind of want to just keep Fox at bay with your good pokes. Like, look at Mario's back here, right? Uh-oh, but here comes the combos.
Ooh, tries to poke with the forward tilt, not going to land, but Light answering back. He was pretty far behind, but now I like the weight on that. He just has to watch for this up smash. Wizzy just going to go for it again and again. And this is where I'm wondering if we're going to see a shift in Light's playstyle. Like I said at the end of the first game, I don't know if Wizzy's going to hit it as easily in the second game. As you can tell, he's just dancing around him using his second jump. But he rolls into it.
And takes the second game. I can't believe it. Dark Wizzy, another up smash, dude. Another up smash. It's very tough, you know, whenever you see Light versus a lot of other characters, he's able to get that that full jump nair, confirm it into an up smash against the likes of Mario. You're not going to be full jumping into him. So what he's doing now is he's mixing up his pressure, right? He's full jumping, then double jumping and landing around Dark Wizzy, respecting that up smash.
What's so scary, too, because even if you're jumping around him, often what people do is they'll mix it up. So I'm short hopping around a shield, and I'm throwing out aerials, but sometimes I'll just go for the run-up grab. You can't do that either because up smash is invincible on Mario. So Light really has to play around this danger zone. It's like an RPS game almost. And now Wizzy is one game away from continuing on in loser's bracket.
Here we go. I love all the pressure that you saw Dark Wizzy putting out, especially with those up, those downers, right? Making it difficult for Light to just jump into the air. It's such a really good tool to just cut off your opponent whenever they want to jump. Okay.
Nice.
Amazing
up,
answer. Yeah, right? Yeah. Dude, it's his airspace, man.
Yeah. He's just controlling the area so well. And he's doing so good offstage, too. It just feels like Light is getting these, like, strings on stage, these up airs, and doing 70 or 80%. As the fourth throw tries to get the back air, but can't quite place it. Gets the second one. What's the play?
Let's trap. No nairs. Okay, gets the grab. Very
nice.
Safe. Resets the situation.
Taking it slow. And there it was. The double neutral air, like you were talking about, has Wizzy boxed to the ledge.
Nice. He gets the tech chase. If they DI out and it's hard for you to get the follow-up, at least tech chase them, as you saw right there from Light.
Oh, goes for the up smash, not going to land. Wizzy with a rare misstep. He usually lands those turnaround grabs all the time. Now Wizzy is struggling as he takes 49% basically for free. He's trying to neutral air out of these combos, I think, but he can't do it. There's that dash attack we talked about before.
Deep recovery right here and immediate there. Good stuff right there. Responding back with the backer just to get center stage. Dark Wizzy conditioning so many times without smash.
Yeah,
sneaks in that grab. You hate to see it.
The nerves. Yeah, sometimes it's the big stage that can get to you.
Mm-hmm. Gotta watch out for that one. Okay, good timing on the landing lag right there. Just getting that there. You don't want to be on that platform against Dark Wheezy, man. His ladder combos are crazy.
Nice trade with that up smash. Not enough to KO just yet, but then he takes basically a free fireball with that. I mean, when you're down 0-2, I don't know if you could be dropping that 3%. Doesn't go for the up smash, but just gets a grab instead.
Oh, and there it is. He's like, get off of me.
Oh, my God.
Yo, the slobber knocker right here.
He's getting big hits.
Mm-hmm.
Light needs to land something. And he needs to do it fast. If he can get this stock off and start working on another one, might be okay. But Wizzy is known to be making these comebacks every time.
Yep, and we're seeing these anti-airs again, Coney. He's not letting them land. Up smash. Still, and it's crazy. Right now, it feels so tense that they're both on their last stock. I had to literally look back down and remember that they're at two stocks apiece, which is actually significant. These guys haven't dropped yet, and I guess I'm a jinx.
You did that. That's your fault. All right, 123 here on Light. He's got to play. Yeah, he's got to. Yeah, you got to respect it, man.
Yep.
I guess I was a liar at the end of game one because Light is just not really respecting the space around Wizzy. He's not making him work for these KOs, not being evasive enough. And I know part of that is Fox. It's just sort of the matchup, but we've seen him play that way before. It just feels like Wizzy is just getting handed some of these KOs.
Oh, absolutely, man. And that's probably because of the fact that Light, you know, might just be set in his ways, right, with the way that he approaches
this character
Fox. It can be hard. That's what makes certain matchups difficult when you have to actually discipline yourself to not do certain things that work on a lot of other characters.
Yep. Nice ledge trapping from Light. Wizzy having trouble making it back. We're just going to do a normal get up, take a little bit of damage, but he still gets center, getting knocked to the right way. 98 to 1. Yeah, we're going to 81.
Good turnaround grab. Barely. And Light didn't even see that one coming. You saw him jump up in his chair.
Hey, goes for the neutral air.
Absolutely amazing delay right there by Light. Watch out. Okay, he gets a perfect hit right there with the down air. Such inconsistent hitboxes. This guy was on the verge of making it, actually getting losing this set 3-0. But taking the third game.
So scary.
Yeah, absolutely scary right here at Genesis 7, man.
Yeah, Wizzy just faltering, kind of dropping shield, eating that down air, which of course is going to lead to that up smash every time. Was he taking a drink from his Mario thermos? Presses a few buttons on his Mario controller.
Dude, he even like talks to people on his Mario phone. Like,
he's a Mario phone.
Like it's like a phone that has like a Mario case. It's like,
oh my God! All right, I bet he's got Mario on speed dial.
Probably does. Dude.
Yep.
Charles Martinet picks up. Right.
Oh my gosh! So right now, Wizzy and Light currently 2-1 in Wizzy's favor. Light looking a little shaky, I want to say, in these games, but was able to pull away in that game. And what we have seen from him over and over is I feel like the longer a set goes, the more options he kind of has unlocked to him. You know what I mean? I feel like he gains momentum very quickly. And game four Light and game five Light can be different animals. So we'll see how he does here. We're back to PS2. No counter picks here.
It's time. That was actually a really interesting movement right there. Gets the knockdown. Whenever you are facing off against Fox and the platforms are that close, you don't want to get knocked down there, especially at lower percents, because you could see how many upgrades he's able to chain, and we've seen like three of them already.
Seeing a few flubs from Wizzy, too. He keeps going for these grabs in the wrong direction.
Coney, game four Light? What's the lore in game four Light?
I not quite as deep as game four Leo, but, you know, maybe one day we'll see. I guess one day we'll see him face off. Maybe this tournament, if Leo drops down to losers, but right now game four Light is just making a run.
Absolutely. Anything is possible here. All right. Here comes the pressure again. Nice by Wizzy to get out of those situations, but he's falling prey to a lot of the anti-airs from Light. Oh, perfect timing right there on the normal getup.
Yeah, dude. Light is cooking. I remember when Light was first coming to power in Smash 4, and a lot of people said his playstyle looked a little unrefined, looked a little raw, and he needed some time to really sort of have a little distinction, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And it feels like we're kind of getting back to that a little bit. He's definitely sort of going back to the old way, and I think it's paying off big. This confidence is what he needs to continue moving on in this tournament.
Oh, he definitely needs it. And Light, but definitely a consistent player just all throughout his Smash career, you know, looking at him even at Genesis the year prior, he was in the top eight, and he makes another top eight showing right here, almost getting sent off to the sky, but still answering back big and trading places with that combo breaker as Dark Wizzy, who has control of the ground.
This is going to be tough, though. Wizzy is just really struggling, lands the back air, and that was perfectly placed. Light trying to stall in the air using that forward air and the second jump.
Oh, big opening to get that grab here, though. No jump. Okay, it looked like he was probably expecting a roll in. Nice respect here by Light. Just doesn't want to get caught, but he drops shield, and there's the up smash.
Again. Light falling into that up smash. I feel like he'll respect it every once in a while, and he'll dodge like one or two. But the third one will hit him. Might not matter too much, though, because he amassed such a giant lead at the beginning of this game. But he has to be careful. Remember, Fox off stage.
Oh, yeah, Fox off stage, definitely a sitting duck. But one thing I wanted to make mention is just, wait a second.
Nice.
Ladies and gentlemen, 2-2 right here. Light, Rogue Light right here, working super hard. Harder than ever understands that he's in a tough situation. He was down, but now tying up the games. Again, guys, these guys are 2-2 in sets. And right now, here at Genesis 7, they are 2-2 in games. Game 5 is coming very, very soon.
And Wizzy looking a little distraught.
Yes, man, he understands that. Dude, this kid, such an amazing story.
Yeah.
In a time where a lot of people aren't quite procuring the same kind of amazing results that he is with Mario, he's doing it. You know, we've seen Prodigy last year. He did a lot of really great work, had an amazing run at Genesis 6.
Yeah.
Coming into this season, though, I remember, like, just two events that passed where you'd see Dark Wizzy literally getting into the top 8.
Yes.
Solo Mario. And now this might potentially, well, for both of these players, this is going to be the end of an amazing run. And I don't want to see either of them go.
Finally utilizing a counter pick here. We're going to Town and City, and I do think this is the right choice. I think staying on PS2 can be a little stubborn, and I think this stage is going to be good for Dark Wizzy, honestly, just because the big flat area, I think he can force Light to sort of respect his airspace a little bit more.
I'm
right
sorry,
now, 61-26.
I just geeked over those like turnaround jabs, man. That was so beautiful.
Yeah.
Amazing tech chases right here by Dark Wizzy, occupying a lot of space. He's being more active. You can see this too.
Yeah.
Not standing still as much, trying to occupy space. Good read on the air, air movement right there. That was so good.
And what he did was he had the flood out and he burst out in the air after coming out of the flood. It's kind of a bait almost to just throw out the flood. Light getting a little too confident going for the down air. And now Wizzy is playing like he did in games 1 and 2. Does Light have an answer?
Let's see. Loss of a jump, that fireball covering
that
Wizzy.
Saved him.
That was so smart, but good DI. Oh, he tried to challenge, but that up smash, you don't want to challenge that move.
Tried to get the up tilt into the back air, I assume.
Fireballs again. It's the jump, and that added platform allows for more layered mix-ups on how he's going to come back on stage. I thought that back air connected.
I thought so, too.
Oh, my gosh.
All right, we're going all the way up. That flood doing a lot. There's an air dodge off stage, but he's not going to make it back just barely. And you could see the disappointment in Wizzy's eyes. He did not want to give up a stock like that, especially not against Fox, like you were saying, a character that can struggle to get the KO sometimes.
Oh, absolutely. Smart fireball right here, though. Light on the other side looking super comfortable, you know. You can tell right now, this is his time. He's trying his best to see to get this W. Okay, beautiful interrupts again. Dark Wizzy with the carry. a rare flub. Yeah.
We don't really see Dark Wizzy messing up those inputs. Seemed like he should have gotten a lot more percent. Doesn't seem to matter too much. He still get up to 89. And I don't know if he would have KO'd off it, maybe off the down air. But right now, Light at 98. Gets the dash attack again. That is just the bane of Light in this set.
Oh, absolutely. Okay. Avoids the threat of a two frame, and now he's back on stage. And Fox's dash is so good. The moment a person goes in the air and tries to read that you'll jump, you could dash underneath and take center so fast.
And this is why I think Town and City is so good for Wizzy. When you get to this FD portion without the platforms and you have to sort of find your way in, you don't have a platform to mix up your movement. You can't drop on it. You just have to run right in and hope he doesn't up smash. He tries to down angle the forward smash. So scary.
Yeah, great mix up right here by Wizzy. I thought the up smash was coming again, and so did Light. Dash attack. He clips him.
He's just stuck off stage.
Oh, there was definitely enough stun, but he didn't get the follow-up. Nair instead. Light.
What a beautiful parry from Light. He's feeling it, man.
Yes,
he wants to go all the way.
Oh, my goodness, right here. Final stock for Dark Wizzy, putting out the up smash. He understands that the time is now, but Light with these reactions. Oh my gosh, a Dark Wizzy strikes back.
Light barely misspacing the follow-up hit. We're in the final stock of this game five. Wizzy and Light leaving it all on Town and City. He's off stage. Wizzy going for the forward air, but it's not gonna land.
Oh man, he really wanted to get that high recovery. Would look so risky right there by Light. Trying to catch the jump. That air dodge, you know things are getting intense when the players do that. Throws him up in the air and he's trying to challenge, but Light strikes back again.
Got two up airs and Light with these parries just again. He is just all over Dark Wizzy.
105.4% Dark Wizzy has to watch out. Okay, I thought that was going to be the end, Cody.
What's the get up? We're going to jump, and I like the jump because the platform's there, but you have to land safely. He gets the down air, but he can't follow up. Uh-oh. Oh no, he's off stage. So scary.
Yes, and this is Fox McCloud. He can definitely get edge guarded. Where's the flood?
He wants to land on the platform. No, he mixes it up and he goes to center instead.
Oh,
he misses the up smash.
What's the recovery option this time, Light? Oh my God! Dark Wizzy moves on.
Inches away from the up smash. Light barely misplacing the lethal blow. Dark Wizzy thanking his lucky stars after that one.
He still can't believe it. You can look at him right now, man, just shaking his head in disbelief. He actually can't believe it. It literally was down to the wire.
Yeah.
Either of those players could have gotten the W. Wow.
That's a fight. The guy threw out the haymaker. You got the dodge that you didn't even really mean to do. He didn't try to avoid it. He didn't do anything. He just barely missed him. And here we go. We're going to look at some highlights from the set. You see Dark Wizzy sort of reeling back his chair after the first game. Here we go. He's pressuring on the platform. Another up smash.
And you were talking about how he was just like conditioning him, going for that raw up smash at first in the beginning, punishing that dash. And then afterwards, just like slowing it down, being defensive. Then you saw he started cooking in game five. Like later on, as the game just kept on going, he started becoming more active and actually making it difficult for Light to want to jump on top of him with Fox.
Yeah, just so scary. And there at the end, you saw the haymaker from both these guys.
Oh yeah.
And Dark Wizzy is going to come out ahead. We got some stats for the game. And look at those kill percents. I mean, you see how even it was. The average, 133 and 128. Both of these guys swinging at each other, making them work for every percent, and just comboing each other to oblivion.
Yeah, both of these guys also just dealing a lot of damage as well. You can see the damage dealt from both of them, Light dealing a bit more, but still, Dark Wizzy, of course, seeing the tools that Mario has, right, just a lot of great edgeguarding tools, he can still be able to not deal that much damage, but take away that stock.
Yeah, just an incredible way to start this Genesis 7 top 8. Don't think we could have asked for a more high-octane match to start this off. And the way that it ended, that's just such a heartbreaker.
Yeah. After such good ultimate that we saw right there on the big stage, and it just, that's what happens, though, right? It gets into a tense moment, and both of those players start itching for those kills. I thought we were going to see that tech chase into the up smash right there and just ending the set, but it's the nerves, man.
Yeah, it really is, and it gets into this tempo where it's like, I swing, you swing, and then sometimes it doesn't go your way. Guys, we're going to kick it over to the next match. Rod, let's go ahead and introduce the next two competitors.
Oh, thanks.